Hi, my name is Mae Borbert, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with DiNovi & Associates. In this video, we'll be talking about telehealth. First, I'd like to distinguish between telemedicine and telehealth. Telemedicine is when the clinician is a participant in distance communication. Telehealth is any use of technology for health purposes. Telehealth has many benefits. One is that through telehealth, home-based behavioral consultation can reach individuals and communities that are otherwise disadvantaged, such as rural areas or communities that have limited or no access to BCBAs. Also, if problem behaviors are severe and transport to a clinical center is too dangerous, telehealth offers a safer alternative. Another benefit to the telehealth model is that it can save behavior consultation agencies time and money by decreasing the time clinicians spend traveling from clients' homes. The field of behavior analysis has been rapidly growing in the past 20 years. The Behavior Analyst Certification Board was established back in 1998. The BACB offers credentials at four different levels: the RBT, the BCABA, the BCBA, and the BCBAD. As the field is growing, so are the demands for behavior analysts worldwide. Telehealth can benefit to meet some of these demands. In the Michalikic et al. Article, the researchers were able to conduct an informed interview with parents and train the parents to implement a functional analysis on their child's problem behavior through the telehealth model. Through the use of a modified behavior skills training, modified due to the modeling component occurring remotely, the parents learned to implement treatment that was comprised of antecedent strategies, functional communication training, differential reinforcement based on the function identified during the functional assessment. A multi-element treatment comparison was utilized, which allowed the parents to trial the intervention strategies, receive information regarding the effectiveness of the intervention strategies, and report, based on their own perspective, how feasible and acceptable the intervention was. Although the telehealth model is ideal for underserved populations, behavior analysts should proceed with caution and ensure they are adhering to our code of ethics when delivering home behavior consultation through a remote platform. Here are some of the codes to look for. Code 2.05, obtain permission for electronic recording of interviews and service delivery sessions for clients and relevant staff in all relevant settings. So prior to providing telehealth services, obtain consent both from the client and all of the staff. The next code to look out for is 2.06, maintain confidentiality. Be sure not to share any information, whether it's written, photographic, or video, about the current clients and supervisees within any social media contexts. Although these are easy ways to share information with any stakeholders, it's important to maintain privacy of the client and the supervisees. Another code is 2.09. Behavior analysts have a responsibility to advocate for the appropriate amount and level of service provision and oversight required to meet the defined behavior change program goals. Advocate for an appropriate amount of level of service delivery and oversight. Telehealth can increase the time behavior analysts have to deliver service by reducing the commute, but should not be used exclusively as the sole service delivery model. Also, be sure that you continue to maintain HIPAA compliance. Use best practices to store data, be aware of any privacy risk, remember to use proper Wi-Fi encryption as well. Have access to the required equipment also before starting any telehealth treatment, such as using a wearable camera, having video conference, and internet-enabled smartphones and tablets are also helpful. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and to disseminate the science, share this video. Thank you.